Hello, everyone, and welcome to Nekoosa for week number 5 of this high school football season. League play kicks off tonight as the Papermakers play host to the Westfield Pioneers in South Central Conference football action. My name is Tom Kirst. Joining me behind the camera is Nita Kirst. We're certainly glad you could join us. As always, our thanks go out to Nekoosa High School and Wisconsin Rapids Community Media for helping us make telecasts of NHS sports possible. Westfield returns to the South Central Conference football scene tonight for the first time in 2 conference years. Due to declining numbers, the Pioneers did not field a team in 2017. Back on the field now, Westfield has started 0-4 in 2018, being outscored by a total of 134-16. Nekoosa hasn't fared much better, though. They, too, are 0-4 on the year with non-conference losses to GET, River Valley, Poinette, and Belleville. Papermakers were shut out in 2 of those contests and have scored only 13 points on the year. Papermakers are led by senior Dylan Bills. He leads the team on both sides of the football, 165 yards rushing and 23 tackles on the season. Westfield's last conference game back on October 14th, 2016. They went out that year with a win, 20-16 over the Dells. They finished 1-8 back in 2016. Nekoosa and Westfield last played on October 7th of 2016. That night, Nekoosa came out the big winner, 35-0 over the Pioneers. Nekoosa in their traditional home blue uniforms. Westfield decked out all in white. Dane Woods puts his foot to the ball, and we are underway. Ball picked up about the 20-yard line. Good run back to about the 20, make it the 32, by number 87, Camden Stamfel. We're going to see a lot of Camden Stamfel tonight for Westfield. He leads the team in rushing and pass receiving. He's also thrown the football 5 times on the air. So Stamfel, a busy guy out there. Westfield, not a whole lot on their roster. As you can see, probably across the field, only a few substitutes on the sideline. I believe they have 18 out for varsity football anyway this year in Westfield, which again is an improvement from last season. Shotgun formation. They'll throw on first down. Trevor Gray hits his man. Omar Ortiz out to about the 41. So a nice gain of about 9 to start the action for Westfield. Second and 1. Hand it off this time. Nothing there for Peyton Freeze.
Peyton Freeze with the carry.
As maybe he got back to the line of scrimmage.
Logan Cleary made the tackle. Pushed it back a couple yards, third down.
Logan Cleary in on the tackle for Nekoosa. Logan, a 6'3", 300-plus player, right in the middle of that defensive line. Nekoosa with a 3-man front. Set of 4 linebackers. Third down now and about 4. They run it again. Ball's on the ground, and I believe Nekoosa has it.
Fumble on the play. Paper-maker football.
Camden Stamfel was the ball carrier. He had the first down, but lost the football at about the 43, and Nekoosa gets it in very good field position here early in the first quarter. A warm night for football, but a beautiful day, as it's been beautiful for the last week. Summertime weather, really. Nekoosa runs it on first down. That's Bills. No, that's not Bills. Chase Loebner with the carry.
Loebner with the run, brought down by Omar Ortiz.
Ortiz on the stop, but not until Loebner picks up about eight. Keegan Colo, the quarterback for the Papermaker, he is a senior. Hands it off this time to Trent Waltenberg, and Waltenberg's got it first down inside the 30.
So
8 yards on first down, 7 on second down, and it's a first down at the 27 now for the Papermakers. Our first ball game of the season, we have not seen the Nekoosa play yet this year. They run it again. Waltenberg lowers his head, runs over a tackler and takes it to about the 15. So Nekoosa really chewing up the yards on the ground. This drive started at the 43. Everybody tight. Two backs behind the quarterback, and we get a whistle. And we're going to get an offside penalty on one team or the other. Westfield.
Penalty goes against Westfield.
First penalty of the night. First and five now, ball at the 10-yard line. Run it wide. Loebner tries to get outside. Hanging on for dear life was number 42, Brandon Chambers. And Chambers did a nice job of keeping Loebner out of the end zone. Gain of about two on the play. Second and three now, the ball at the 8-yard line. Whistle, and we're going to get offside now on Nekoosa. So Nekoosa gives that 5 yards right back simply by lining up offside. And now second and two turns into second and eight. The ball back at the 12-yard line. Bills on the left side, he finds a lot of room. Takes it inside the five, and that's gonna be first down yardage for the Papermakers. A quick hitter that time with Dylan Bills. His first carry picks up 10, and now Nekoosa first and goal from the 4-yard line. From the right hash mark. Nekoosa runs it right. That's Bills again, and he busts his way into the end zone. Dylan Bills takes it in from 4 yards out, and the Papermakers strike first. They lead 6-0 now with 8:43 to play here in the opening period. 43-yard drive by the Papermakers following the fumble recovery. And all that yardage coming on the ground. Six plays, 43 yards. Dane Woods on to attempt the try, and he splits the upright. 8:43 to play, first quarter, 7-0, Nekoosa. Dane Woods ready to kick it away for a second time here in the opening period. Camden Stamfel from the 20. The kicker Woods first down there. He missed him. But I tell you what, number 34.
Camden Stamfel on the return.
Sawyer Niprath did not miss him.
Finally hit brought down by Sawyer Niprath.
Good tackle by Niprath. They're going to spot the ball at the 24-yard line. So Westfield, with their second possession, they did move the football their first possession. Fumbled it away after three plays. Little pitch to Stanfield this time, nothing to it.
Trent Waltenberg
right there to throw Stanfield to the turf. Looks like he lost a yard.
Lost him about a yard, second down.
Westfield started the game throwing the football. He completed a pass. Since then, we've seen four runs. This time, passing formation, two receivers split left, two split right, a single back behind the quarterback. And before he can get rid of the ball, the quarterback is buried, and he is down, and he is injured. That was Waltenberg in that time on Gray. And Gray took a big hit. I think they ruled that an incomplete pass, but I see the officials are getting together now to talk it over. Nekoosa did recover the football. And I'd be surprised if they end up calling that a fumble. But I've been surprised before. Yeah, they're going to mark it back to the line of scrimmage, to 23. That's going to be third down. I think. They're still talking about it. I don't see any flags out there. No. Nekoosa's excited. But the officials are still discussing something. If it was a fumble, why would they give Nekoosa the ball back at the original line of scrimmage? Shouldn't it be where they recovered the football, which was down near the 10? So I'm uncertain. Let's put it that way. Well, here comes the referee back to the middle of the field. And he says, Westfield football. So yeah, a lot of confusion. I think it's
being ruled an incomplete.
It is third down. They got that right now. Third and 11. Well, that last time, Waltenberg, who's one of the inside linebackers for Nekoosa, came through untouched. And Gray didn't have a chance to get rid of that football at all. Now we get a whistle from the referee, and I'm not sure what that's about. Well, now they say second down, too. That's not right. Gray's going to roll out and throw. Got a man, a good catch, good throw. Omar Ortiz with the reception. Out to about the 44-yard line. A gain of about 20 on the play. Gray now 2 out of 3 throwing the football. So I guess it really doesn't matter in the end now, does it, what down it was. Westfield took care of that for us. First and 10 from the 42, they run it.
Stanfield on the run.
Camden Stanfield.
Ike Dillon in the
tried to pick his way through the middle, but couldn't find a thing. Well, they do give him a yard. Second down and 9, the ball at the 42. You know, Nekoosa 0-4 coming into this game tonight, but you've got to consider, too, they played a pretty tough non-conference schedule. Oh, Stanfield wide open over here. Nekoosa does a good job of getting back into play, but Stanfield picks up about 4.
Camden Sample on the screen.
Waltenburg puts him down.
Trent Waltenburg and Colin Gustafson bring him down.
Third down and about five. Going back to that non-conference schedule now for Nekoosa, those four opponents they played had a combined record of 13-3 after four games. So they played some pretty good competition. Gray in trouble again and finally brought down. About five papermakers giving chase. And Dane Woods finally put him away. So a big loss on the play of about eight. And Westfield with the punt team on. Who else? Camden Stample. Back to kick it away for Westfield. Stample's gonna run it. He's got a first down and more. And Westfield with a little gadget play catches Nekoosa sound asleep.
Picked up a first down for the Pioneers.
18 yards on the run for Stample. And a new set of downs for the Pioneers. Ball now at the Nekoosa 45. So again, the blue defense needs to go back to work. Get a stop. Camden Stample with a little movement in the backfield that time. It's going to cost his team 5 yards. Second penalty on Westfield here in the first quarter. Bray in trouble again. Brought down, misses the ball. I'm not sure if he fumbled that forward or if that's going to be a really incomplete pass. There is a flag on the play as well. The official right in front of us. And that appears to be on Nekoosa as the papermakers heading back inside their own 40. Ball was at midfield, first and 15. Is that an illegal participation penalty? I'm not sure. So Nekoosa have 12 players on the field, maybe? Nekoosa's second penalty. Quick throw.
Cade Kangas on the reception.
Cade Kangas with
Riley
a catch.
Dye brings him down.
Nice little play by the Pioneers. Quick receiver screen. They picked up about seven. Second down about four. Westfield has had a lot of success here in the opening period throwing the football. Not for big chunks, but just for some steady yards. That one went right through the hands of the intended receiver, Brandon Chambers. I think that's only the second time that Gray has missed a receiver. He has four completions and six attempts. Third down now, third down and three. Two receivers left, one right. I'll make that two right. Gray. He's got the first down. Just got enough squirming through the middle before he was brought down by Carson Allison. And maybe I spoke a little prematurely. I thought he had the line. But I see they marked the football just short of the line.
Looks like we're going to get a visit from the chain gang.
So our first measurement of the evening. Five conference football games coming up in the next 5 weeks here for Nekoosa. Three of those at home. Next week they'll be home against Wautoma. I believe the road games they have this season in the conference anyway are Wisconsin Dells and Adams Friendship. Adams Friendship, the last ball game on the year. And I believe Nekoosa has Mauston for homecoming that first Friday in October. Fourth down and inches. Little confusion on the snap.
Good second effort by
Boy, Grader did a nice job of stretching the football out. I don't know if they're going to give him the yardage, though. I don't think that's a good mark. That's not a good mark. The other linesman coming in right now, and maybe they're going to discuss the position of the football. But Grade, before his knee went down, he definitely extended the ball over the 35-yard line, but they did not give him that mark, meaning the officials, of course. But to me, the ball looks like it's in the same place it was last measurement. They need the line, and they're not going to get it. Oh, they got it.
First down for the Pioneers.
How about that? Third first down in the half for the Pioneers, and they keep the football. New set of downs from the 35. Again, two receivers left and right. Single back from the shotgun. Gray fires it across the middle. He's got him. Man down inside the 10-yard line is number 80, Brady Holly.
Finally brought down by Drew.
And a
Goldmeier.
Nice pitch and catch that time by Gray.
That brings up
to
Holly.
30 yards on the play. And Westfield knocking at the door now. First and goal from the 5. I have been impressed with that passing game that we've seen from Westfield thus far. You know, on the year, they've only been throwing the ball about 10, 12 times a game. They're going to have that many throws here in the first quarter. Stample, nothing on the right side.
A bunch of paper makers finally bring down
lost
Cameron
a couple.
Stample.
The ground game not so good right now for Westfield. Everything's come through the air. This drive started from their own 24-yard line. So they've marched about 70 yards with the majority of that coming in the air. Again, a spread formation. Gray misses his man out there to the left.
Pass is incomplete. That'll bring up third down.
As did our camera person. Trust me, incomplete. Yeah, they've thrown the ball 8 times here in the first period. Completed 5. We still have 4 minutes to play in the first quarter. Third down and goal. A little confusion that time. I'm not sure who Gray was shooting at.
Incomplete one.
He had a man
again,
short and he had a man deep. And I think Peyton Freeze, the man short, got in the way of the intended receiver who was standing in the end zone. So now Westfield, evidently without a kicker, because they're going to go for it here on fourth down. Expect a lot of pressure this time from Nekoosa. Again, they have that 3-man front. I would expect at least a couple of linebackers coming here. Good pressure that time on the football.
Pass incomplete. Papermaker take over on
by number 34, Sawyer Niprath.
Special thank you in advance, ladies and gentlemen.
He made the play extremely hard for the quarterback, Gray.
Nothing major.
And Nekoosa takes the ball over on down. So a very nice drive for Westfield, but they come up dry. No points. And now Nekoosa with the football deep in their own territory. 3:50 to play yet here in the first quarter. Nekoosa spreads it out. Single back behind the quarterback. They hand it to the man in motion. That's Loebner, I believe. He makes a good cut and gets over the 10 out to about the 12. No, that's Dane Woods, excuse me.
Down by Riley Verhagel.
So about 4 yards on the carry for Woods. Second and 6. Where Nekoosa, or Westfield's been everything through the air, Nekoosa's been everything on the ground. And whistles before the snap. Another pre-snap penalty, this one on Nekoosa. It's gonna be an offside penalty. They're second in the quarter. Three penalties, 15 yards here in the opening period. Nekoosa coached, of course, by Mr. Paul Lieber. Paul in his third season leading the team. Across the field, Josh Cheek in his first season coaching the Westfield Pioneers. Ball's on the ground, and I believe Westfield got it.
Fumble on the play, recovered by Westfield.
Is a good determined run, and I'm not sure who the ball carrier was.
Reminder, the football games are broadcast in the Wisconsin Rapids Community Media, Solaris Channel 3 and Spectrum 985.
So about 8 yards on the carry.
Monday evening, and also on YouTube, just do a search for Nekoosa football.
So Westfield gets it back from their own 20. Make that the Nekoosa 20. They run the draw, Stample, good cut, down to the 15. Breaks a tackle inside the 10 to the 8 yard line. Good
Camden
run
with the
by Camden Stample.
Clayton Havlovic brings him down.
Probably the longest gain from scrimmage tonight on the ground by Pioneers. Their fourth first down. And again, first and goal, this time from the 8. Two running backs with the quarterback this time. They hand it off to the first man, and he's down near the goal line. I believe that was number
seven,
Freeze, on the carrier.
Riley Dye in on the tackle.
Peyton Freeze takes it down to about the 1 yard line. Second and goal, Pioneers. 2 minutes to play, first quarter. Nekoosa leads by 7. Freeze again. Touchdown, Westfield.
Touchdown, Westfield. Peyton Freeze pushes it in.
So this time, Westfield finishes the drive. 20 yards on 4 plays. Peyton Freeze takes it in from the 2 yard line. 7-6 our score, and Westfield will go for 2. Same formation, 2 backs with the quarterback. 1 behind, 1 next to the quarterback. This time, quarterback keeps it and he's gonna go down.
And the conversion is no good.
Good play that time by number 82 for Nekoosa. Austin Sutherland. 1:49 to play first quarter. It's now Nekoosa 7 and Westfield 6. Westfield kicks it away. Oh, a short kick. Onside kick. Who got the football? Westfield.
Onside kick. Westfield
Pioneers
football.
For the second time here in the first quarter surprised the Papermakers. First was a fake punt, and now an onside kick following a score. And Westfield again with very good field position, not quite inside the 10 this time, but it is the Nekoosa territory at the 47. First down and 10. Got a man. Little miscommunication that time between the quarterback Bray and Brady Holly. Holly was open, but he really didn't know the ball was in the air. Trevor Gray, now 6 out of 10. Throwing the football here in the first quarter. Freeze, short run, gain of about 1.
Stand up to Peyton Freeze.
Again, number 82, Austin Sutherland in on the stop. Boy, that Nekoosa defense has been on the field a lot here in the first half. Third down and about 8. Gray, again, trying to get the ball to Holly.
Pass incomplete.
Brady Holly not quite tall enough to pull down that one. You know, it's a matter of time before I say Buddy Holly, but that was Brady Holly. Oh, we got a penalty on the play, too. I'm sorry I missed that. I would think Nekoosa would decline this penalty. I would think. It's third down and about 9. Well, it's going to be fourth down and 9, I should say. So it's a legal man downfield, and it is declined. And again, the punt team on for Westfield. Camden Stample back there one more time. I believe that's Cordero Esquerdo back to return the punt. And he will get a chance this time. Nope, he's going to let it roll. Turns out to be a very good punt for Stample as he pins Nekoosa back inside their 10 again. So about 41 yards on the punt. And Nekoosa's going to take over where? About the 5-yard line? We'll call it the 6-yard line. 57 seconds to play in the first quarter, and it's been a long first quarter. But interesting. Nekoosa backed up toward their own goal line again. First and 10 from the 6. They run it left. Find a little bit of room, but a flag comes in.
Niprath, the ball carrier, but there's a flag on the play.
Niprath was the ball carrier. Flag came in from the side judge. Probably a hold or a clip or a block in the back. I'm not sure what they picked up on that play.
Penalty goes against Westfield.
Oh, it goes on Westfield. I'll be darned. You know, this officiating crew is not winning any awards for speed. And now the referee going over to talk to the Westfield sideline again. I'm not sure why. Yeah! So did they actually make a call on anybody? I haven't seen the ball move. Now they're going to move the football. From the six, they're going to mark off 15. They'll make that 10 yards. Out to the 16, and I never did see a... It can't be a holding penalty on the defense. Maybe a legal hand to the face or something like that. We'll call it that. Another penalty. Procedure this time on Nekoosa.
This one pushes the papermakers back.
Nekoosa's fourth penalty here in the first quarter. Your second procedure penalty. So that backs them up to the 11, first and 15. Caldo dropped the football, picked it back up, and he did get away to a running back. Short gain by Dane Woods, out to about the 12.
Dane Woods gets brought down by Peyton Freed.
So like 1 yard on the carry. Second down and about 14 now. Boy, Nekoosa started out this ball game really executing well on offense. Big chunks of yardage. Like this one. Good run right through the middle. That's Dylan Bills. And he's got a first down out to the 32-yard line. So Bills takes a 20 yards. Nekoosa with their fourth first down. Trent Waltenberg on the carry, excuse me.
And that's going to bring us to the end of the first quarter.
Clock runs down, and the first quarter is history. We played one here in Nekoosa. Our score, Nekoosa 7 and Westfield 6. Second quarter begins with Nekoosa at the 27-yard line. They do have a first down, first and 10. Two receivers right and left. Woods hands it off, and Westfield swarms the ball carrier. Short gain on the play. Esquerdo, no, excuse me, that was 35. I'm not sure who 35 is. Is that Esquerdo?
Versian Gamel with the carry.
No, that's Versian Gamel.
Mason Peters.
Or Gamel. Yeah. So he's not number five, he's number 35. And I think that was Gamel too on the punt return a few minutes ago. Yard on the play, second and 9. Gamel again. This time with a good run over the 40.
Percion Gamel with the carry, brought down by Omar.
15 yards for Gamel. Out to the 43-yard line. Versian, a 5'6", 170-pound junior. He's built low to the ground. And it looks like he's got some quickness. Delay as they get the chains set up. Everybody tied on first down. Gamble again. Puts his head down this time, takes it right out to the 45, make that the 50. So another nice gain of 6 yards. Nekoosa, 10 rushes, 76 yards in that first quarter. Had nothing through the air, didn't even attempt to pass in that first quarter. They stick to the ground here. Short of the first down is Bills. So Dylan Bills takes it for about 3. It leaves another yard to go. Why don't you love the down marker they have over there? I don't know how it lights up like that. I thought it was a reflection from the sun before, but You certainly don't have any sun right now. Straight ahead, Dane Woods gets the first down.
Dane Woods finally gets brought down by Peyton Freeze.
Nekoosa's sixth first down on the night. And they are heading the right way here. Get that ground game going again. Boy, you can control the clock. You can control the game with a good running game. Right in front of us, near side of the field. Woods in motion, and again a whistle. And we're going to get a false start or a procedure penalty.
That'll be against Nekoosa.
Couldn't tell you on who. So Nekoosa not helping themselves with penalties, that's for certain. First and 15 now, the ball at the 47. Everybody tight. Colo in trouble. Throws it away. He did have Woods. He did have Woods in the area. And that's going to go down as an incomplete pass. Still second and 15. The first pass attempt tonight by Keegan Colo. Straight ahead. I think that's Waltenberg, but I'm not sure.
Bill's a carrier.
Nope. It was Bills this time, 23 and 33. Proven to be a challenge for me. So Nekoosa moving the ball nicely, shot themselves in the foot with that procedure penalty on first down. Then tried to go through the air. Lost it down there. So now they're facing third and 11. Ball at the 42-yard line of Westfield. Waltenberg in motion. Colo. Bills, they set up the screen nicely. Dylan Bills, one man to beat. 5. Touchdown, Nekoosa. What a nice call and nice execution that time.
Dylan Bills on the screen.
Boy, the paper makers set that screen up beautifully. And Dylan Bills in the end zone for the second time tonight. This time a 43-yard pass from Keegan Colo. Nekoosa on top, 13-6. Dane Woods on to attempt the point.
And the extra point
kick
is good.
So Woods, two for two on the night. 8:14 to play, first half. It's now Nekoosa 14 and Westfield 6. 14-6 lead. Dane Woods will kick it away. Stample the man deep for Westfield. Camden from the 25. Slips a couple of tackles, gets outside, grabbed by the shirt, and pulled out of bounds by number 88,
down by Hoyt Olson.
Good play by Olson, but a good return by Stample out to the near the 40-yard line. We're going to mark it at the 39, I believe, maybe the 38. Looks like the 38 and a half, doesn't it, Nita? Yeah. So Westfield, first down. First down from the 39. Two receivers left, two right from the shotgun. Man wide open. Gray missed him. That was Holly right in the middle of that Nekoosa secondary. Second down and 10. One of the few bad balls that's been thrown tonight by the quarterback, Trevor Gray. He had a good first half. Hands it off this time. And Nekoosa, three papermakers swarm upon the ball carrier. Waltenberg is there.
Colin Gustafson.
As is number 73, Jimmy Schaefbauer. And we're going to get a timeout on the field. Timeout, 7:52 to play in the half, 14-6, Nekoosa. Third down and 11 from the Westfield 38-yard line. Gray. Westfield with their own little screen pass. Stample chased down by Trent Waltenberg. Well, Waltenberg made the play. He probably saved quite a bit of yardage that time. Stample. Wants it away. Waltenberg back this time. He's going to let it roll as well. And another good exchange by Campbell. Stample.
Mr. Kirst is always broadcasting.
As he pins Westfield down, or make that Nekoosa down inside their own 20-yard line.
And on YouTube. Again, look for Nekoosa football.
So the papermakers, fresh off a good drive, now have 82 yards to go for that next score. 7:02 to play here in the first half. On first down, they run the football. Gamble off the left side, picks up a nice gain of about five. Second down. Clock running, 6:42 to play in the half. You know, between these two teams, they had only scored four touchdowns entering tonight's action. Here we have three already in the first half. Big run here, look out. That's Dane Woods. Holly giving chase, forces Woods to change direction, and he's finally brought down at the 24-yard line. So Holly made a good play to keep Woods out of the end zone, but Dane with a big gain of 26 plus another 26, 52 yards on the run. And Nekoosa quickly down in Westfield territory. 6:14 to play, timeout on the field. So Westfield's used a couple of timeouts here in the first half. They have one left. Nekoosa runs the ball on first down, another big hole up the middle. I believe that's Waltenberg this time. And he's down.
Brings down Waltenberg.
So Waltenberg with a good run, but he stays down after the run. Now he's getting up. I don't know if he's got a cramp. A little bruise there, but Trent looks fine. Jogs back to the Nekoosa sideline. picks up, 13 on the play. And Nekoosa knocking at the door. Started this drive from their own 18-yard line. They now sit at the 11 of their opponent, first and 10. Everybody tied on first down. Colo hands it off. Dylan Bills busts inside the five. And they're going to mark him just short of the goal line, I believe.
Dylan Bills, the carrier, rules down just short of the line.
It should be another first down for Nekoosa. First and goal, ball at the 1 yard line. Colo hands it off.
Touchdown,
Nekoosa. I believe, I'm
Sawyer
not sure,
Niprath with the carry.
It was Sawyer Niprath with a 2 yard run. Nekoosa's third touchdown here in the first half. Niprath from 2 yards out. Dane Woods on to attempt his third extra point tonight. We get a little whistle before that though. And Westfield's offside. It's interesting. Let's see what Nekoosa does here.
Penalty being assessed offsides against Westfield.
They marked the ball at the 3 yard line for these conversions.
After the kickoff, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do 50-50 to get your tickets out.
So I don't know if it's half the distance to the goal. So Nekoosa picks up a yard and a half. Almost tempted here, I would think, to go for two. Woods hammers it through. Three for three for Dane.
And the extra point is
5:21 to play, first half. It's now Nekoosa 21 and Westfield 6. Dane Woods. Stample from the 20. Hey, if he gets outside here, he's got some room. Camden Stample takes it into Nekoosa territory to the 46-yard line.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, 50-50
nice run.
Drawing.
Nice return by Camden Stample.
$34. Those, all those proceeds going off to the junior class. We got number 689163.
So Westfield with the football. They're going to huddle up over by their head coach, Coach Chief.
Meet a representative of the junior class down behind.
Ball's marked for play. 5:11 to play yet here in the half. Nekoosa leading by 15. Again, Nekoosa with two touchdowns in four games. Coming into tonight's game, they've got three here in the first half. That's got to feel good for that Nekoosa offense. Two receivers left and right, single back behind the quarterback. Stample. Hey, nice cut. Boy, I tell you, that kid's a pretty good football player. Camden Stample's only a sophomore. He takes it down to the 40, a 7-yard pickup. Of course, this Westfield team is pretty young. But I do have a stat somewhere on their ages. But they have many more underclassmen than they do seniors. I think they only have a couple of seniors. Man is open, nice move on the football. Number 44, Riley Dye, he stuck his hand in there. He make a good cut on the football. Otherwise, Holly was open again in the middle of that defense. Checking out Riley Dye. It looks like he's the outside linebacker on that side. He's got to cover that slot receiver. Ball on the ground. Nekoosa's going to get it. They've got it. That's Gamble. And he's still struggling.
Garcian.
Make that Versian. Versicon. Dammel with a good play. He's going to need New Jersey after that play. If he would have had a breakaway jersey there, he might be standing in the end zone. Second time Westfield's given it back to Nekoosa tonight via the fumble. Still 4:17 to play in the half. Nekoosa with three timeouts. And they have a first down at the 44-yard line. Bills. Wrapped up by number 67.
Corbin Tipton.
After a short game. Three yards on the play for Bills. Second down. Clock running under 4 minutes now. Play in the half. Nekoosa has not completed a pass here in the first half, yet lead 21-6. They're going to throw here. Colo won't get a chance as he is buried by number 67 and 68. Tipton and Tyler Warren. Put Colo down, Keegan down. A loss of about 8 on the play. Third down and big yardage. You know, I say Nekoosa hasn't completed a pass yet. They have in this game. They've got that screen pass for a touchdown. Hey, a lot of opening out here for Bills. Breaks a tackle. He's got a first down.
Dylan Bills with the carry.
He needed 15. He got 17.
Paper maker first down.
And Dylan Bills starting to pile up the yards. Bills with a couple of scores tonight. Niprath with the other touchdown for Nekoosa. Looking for number 4 here before the half ends. 2:50 to play in the half. Clock running. Loebner. Jace with a good run.
Omar.
Near first down yardage.
Jace Loebner.
They mark him right at the stick. I guess it's going to be second down. So 9 yards for Loebner on the carry. Second and short, 2:30 to play in the half. Waltenberg bruises his way down to about the 5 yard line.
Waltenberg finally brought down by Brady Holly and Weston Hoppa.
They're going to mark it at the
6. Maker first down.
18 yards. First and goal, 2:14 to play in the half. Now Westfield, I think, is running, wearing down a little bit defensively against this Nekoosa run game. Loebner, good cut, touchdown, Jace Loebner.
Touchdown.
So Jace Loebner takes it 6 yards.
Punched in by Jace Loebner.
And Nekoosa extends their lead now to 21 points. With a chance at another one here by Dane Woods as he'll attempt to try. He's been perfect tonight. And he remains that way.
And
well, he's been solid.
Good.
1:58 to play in the half. It's now Nekoosa 28 and Westfield 6. So with a minute 58 to play here in the half, Woods with a little number this time as a kickoff, covered up at the 40-yard line by number 56, Riley Verhaslett. So good field position for Westfield. They've got a minute 58 yet to play in the half. They have one timeout. They had a lot of success throwing the football in the first quarter, not so much here in the second. But they've had open receivers. So So they still got a shot here with a minute 57 to play in the half. From the shotgun, Gray steps up. He's got some room. Ooh, hit hard up near midfield by Dylan Bills.
Gamble and Bills team up to bring up Trevor Gray.
About 9 yards on the run by Gray. Well, NFL, that probably would have drew a flag that time, don't you think? A little high head, too. A little helmet-to-helmet type stuff. I'm not sure what how the rules have changed in high school football concerning tackling. Second and one. Gray. Surprised his receiver Ortiz out here. Ortiz not really looking for the football. Third down. Minute 11 to play now in the half. Nekoosa finished 3-2 in conference play last season. Of course, one of those wins was that forfeit from Westfield. Beat Adams Friendship last ball game of the year to get into the playoffs, but dropped their first tournament game to Osceola, I believe it was. Gray in trouble here, he goes down. 38-72.
John Barton chases down the runner.
John Barton is 38-72 is Ryan Doherty. They sack the Westfield quarterback. Fourth down coming up. Fourth and about five. Westfield still has a timeout, but they're letting the clock run right now. It's down to about 35 seconds. And I almost think they're going to let it run down and use their last timeout for some reason. Don't quite understand the strategy. No, they're going to just let it run down. They're going to take a penalty. Nope, they took the timeout. So 13 seconds to play. Thus far in the conference this year, Boston has had the best of it. They're 3-1 in non-conference play. Wautoma 2-2, Wisconsin Dells and Adams Friendship 1-3. Westfield and Nekoosa, of course, 0-4 entering action tonight. Other games tonight. To kick off the conference season, Boston is at Wautoma, and Adams Friendship is at Wisconsin Dells. Next week, we'll be right back here at Holland Field as Wautoma comes to town. The Hornets and the Papermakers, 7 o'clock next Friday night here in Nekoosa. Other ball games next week, Boston at Adams Friendship, and Westfield plays host to Wisconsin Dells. So Dylan Bills, the leading rusher for Nekoosa this season, had 165 yards coming into tonight's game. And he's going to go over 100 tonight, I would think. Might even meet that 165-yard mark. Double up his yardage tonight. Of course, Waltenberg, Woods, Gamel, they've all had good nights running the football. Stanfield looks like he's going to punt the football again, and he does. Short kick, that one's gonna end up out of bounds. Taken by John Kokoka over there. Nice play by John. One of the Nekoosa coaches. 10 seconds yet to play in the half. Excuse me, Nekoosa will get it at their own 40-yard line, I would think. Nekoosa will just run the football here. Maybe even take a knee. They've enjoyed a good first half. Though it was a long first half. It's worth it when you're ahead, right? From the shotgun, he surprises me. They throw the football. Loebner picks up about seven, and that's gonna be the half.
Loebner with the reception.
So Nekoosa heads off.
Tackle made by Ortiz.
To talk it over, And they've got some good things to talk about. It's halftime. Our score, Nekoosa 28 and Westfield 6. Second half about to begin. Nekoosa, comfortable 28-6 halftime lead. Papermaker scored first in this ball game. First quarter, Dylan Bills took it in from 4 yards out. They led 7-0 after the Danewoods PAT. Westfield fought back though. Peyton Free scored on a 2-yard run. 7-6 Nekoosa after one quarter. Nekoosa with a big second quarter. Dylan Bills, a 43-yard pass from Keegan Colo. Ball on the ground. I think Nekoosa got that thing. Niprath scored from 2 yards out, and Jace Loebner from 6 yards out. As Nekoosa really ran up the rushing yardage in that second quarter. 16 carries, 158 yards. I have for Nekoosa in quarter number two. They had 76 yards in the first quarter. So what, 134? Make that 234 yards rushing here in the first half. So they are taking it to Westfield on the ground. First and 10 from the 43. Oh, collision in the backfield, but Gamble sprints out of there, heading toward the goal line. Touchdown. Versian Gamble. What a way to start the second half, huh? 57 yards.
57 yards.
To pay dirt, and Nekoosa increases their lead now to 34-6. 14 seconds into this second half. Boy, the papermaker's really chewing up the yards on the ground. They're approaching 300 yards rushing already here, very early in the second half. Flag on the PAT attempt. It's going to go against somebody. Again, the official's very slow in marking off penalties, figuring things out tonight. So it's a procedure call finally against Nekoosa. And they're going to mark the ball off now, and Woods will attempt the point 5 yards deeper. Colo's the holder, by the way. Not a good snap, but a good hold and a good kick. So Woods knocks it through, 11:46 to play. Third quarter. It's now Nekoosa 35, Westfield 6. Woods has it teed up, waiting for the official. And now the ball in play, very short kick this time. Grabbed at about the 35-yard line and brought up over the 40 by number 3, which I do not have in my program.
Blake Olson with the tackle.
Olson on the stop for Nekoosa, that's Hoyt Olson. So Westfield puts it in play from their own 42-yard line. Pioneers had a lot of success throwing the football in the first quarter, not so much in the second quarter. Of course, Nekoosa dominated, with that ground game in the second half. Make that second quarter. Two backs in the backfield with the quarterback. Freeze with the football, it takes it about 2 yards. Brought down by Waltenberg and Olson.
Brought down by Austin Sutherland.
Austin Sutherland, the other tackler, number 82. Austin, a senior. Austin playing that left end position right now for Nekoosa. Colin Gustafson, the nose tackle, and John Barton, the right end. Another good play by Sutherland as he pulls down the quarterback, Gray.
Sutherland brings down Gray.
For no gain. So Austin with the first two tackles here in the second half. Or you have a small roster like Westfield has. You got everybody, pretty much everybody, playing both ways. That can wear you down. When I say both ways, I mean offense and defense. Another good stop, short gain on the run. Surprises me Westfield didn't throw the ball on that possession. Now they face a fourth and sixth. The other thing you have to worry about if you're Westfield, excuse me, is injuries. You know, you're thin to begin with, and then you lose a few of your key folks, and you're really living on the edge. Stample, one of those key folks, back to punt. It's a nice kick. Waltenberg trying to get the corner. Didn't quite get there. Good return though by Trent.
Brandon Chambers.
Out to the 32-yard line. Trent Waltenberg, a 6'2", 195-pound junior. So Nekoosa takes it from the 32-yard line. Their second possession here in the second half. Of course, that first possession, the one play, touchdown run by Gamble. Woods this time, lots of room. Dane Woods, 11 yards and a first down.
Papermaker, first down.
And again, I think that Westfield defense is just getting worn down. Now, one more score, and Nekoosa will force a running clock in this ball game. Oh, ball on the ground. Westfield's going to get a shot at it here, and they may have it. Nope, Nekoosa got it back. Fumble exchange, and Colo got back on the football.
He can go and recover that fumble.
Loss of about a yard on the play. More importantly, Nekoosa still with the football. Papermakers finished 3-2 in the conference last season, 4-7 overall. Watoma was the conference winner last season. Bill's picking his spot nicely. Out near a first down.
Bring up third down.
A little short though. They're going to mark him a yard short. Third and one. So defending conference champion Watoma right here at Holland Field next Friday night. So come on out and catch the action. As tonight marks the halfway point already in the season. Big hole this time for Bills. Dylan in a foot race, and he's going to win it. Five, touchdown, Dylan Bills.
There's a flag on the play.
A flag back at the 48-yard line. We'll have to check that out. And it's going to be a hold on Nekoosa. So it's coming back. And like everything else tonight, it's coming back slowly. So the referee made the call on that play. Center of the line found the hole. So that nullifies a good 47-yard run by Bills. Boy, Dylan showed some speed there at the end of that run. So now the ball back to the Nekoosa 43-yard line. And it's third down and about 10. Everybody tight. They run it. Woods. Dane Woods has the first down. Good blocking up front, good blocking downfield. As Woods takes it to the 42-yard line. So 16 yards and a first down for Dane Woods. He's had a good night too. Also kicking the football, he's had a very good night. 5 for 5 PATs. First and 10. Coldwell swamped by Freeze. Freeze on a blitz that time from his linebacker position, timed it perfectly. And he was in the backfield as soon as Coldwell had the football. Loss of 2 on the play, second down. Waltenberg drags a tackler inside the 40.
Ortiz brings down Waltenberg.
Omar Ortiz on the stop. But again, I think Waltenberg dragged Ortiz about 3 yards that time. So about 5 yards on the carry. Still about 7 needed for a first down. It is third down from the 38. Straight ahead, Trent Waltenberg fights for yardage. He's got a first down at the 30.
Waltenberg ball carrier.
And Nekoosa continues to chew up the yards.
Tackler was Schoffacher.
6:27 to play here in the second, or make that third quarter. Watching Nekoosa coach down there, I thought he was going to stand on the bench and it started to tip. I thought he was going down for a second. Dylan Bills with a good cut inside. Dylan turns on the Jets again and he's in the end zone. Touchdown. No flags. Dylan Bills with his third score tonight, this one from 31 yards. And Nekoosa now up by 35. So we're gonna have a running clock the rest of the night. So Bills have scored on a 4-yard run, a 43-yard pass, and now a 31-yard run. Colo the holder. Woods. Right down the middle. 6 minutes to play, third quarter. It's now Nekoosa 42 and Westfield 6. New kicker this time. Number 70 is going to put it away for Nekoosa. And unfortunately, I don't have a 70 in my program. Maybe I read that wrong. 76 maybe? Yeah, no 76 either.
Hunter Boudreaux with the kickoff.
Always Hunter Boudreaux. Number 78 with a kickoff. Thank you, Steve Bouchard. .534 to play, clock running now. Nekoosa up by 36. High school rule, a team gets ahead of another by 35 or more in the second half and the clock runs. It will stop for timeouts. It will stop after scores, but otherwise it'll continue to run. Regardless of what Westfield does scoring the rest of the game. Short run by Freeze.
Peyton Freeze the carrier. Brent McChesney in on the tackle.
McChesney in on the tackle. Brent, a 5'11", 150-pound sophomore. See some new numbers in the ball game now. McChesney is the right tackle. Nekoosa with a four-man front now. A little different. Stample gets to the outside, tossed out of bounds around the 40.
Cordero with
Squirtle
with the tackle.
And Squirtle with the tackle. I thought I saw 31 over there. And again, I don't have a 31 in my program. Third down and 5 from the 38. Stample, he's going to get a first down. He's going to get more. Stample in the clear, 30, 20, 10, pushed out of bounds, saving tackle.
Stample the carrier.
Down around the 6-yard line.
The Squirtle pushes him out of bounds.
And with that play, a whole new team goes in for Nekoosa defensively. So I'm not sure if that was the JVs out there. Or now the JVs are out there. No, I think you're seeing the regular defense out there now from Nekoosa. Nice run, though, by Stample. First and 10. The ball is positioned at the 11-yard line. Stample again. Not this time.
Stample the carrier. Logan Cleary in on the tackle.
Cleary and Waltenberg in on the tackle for Nekoosa. 2:40 to play in the quarter. Second down and 15. Big loss that time for Westfield on that running play. Pioneers in the huddle for a long time here. Got something brewing this time. Something special. Two backs next to the quarterback. They're going to throw. Gray in trouble. Going to go down. 34, Sawyer Niprath. Put him down.
Sawyer Niprath with the tackle.
Yeah, the quarterback, Gray, tried to throw the ball away at the last second. And I'm not sure how they're going to treat that. They're going to call it an incomplete pass? They are. I didn't really see any receivers near the quarterback. So it easily could have been a grounding call as well. Third down. Third down and 15. Ball out at the 17. Gray. Got down to about the 10-yard line, and that's about it. Fourth down coming up.
Trent
I'm
Waltenberg.
Sure Westfield
finally
will go here.
Down. Trevor Gray, gonna bring up fourth down.
Just under a minute now to play here in the third. Fourth down and 5 for a first down. The ball's at about the 6. Gray throws it back toward Stample.
Stample, the intended receiver.
That play just wasn't there. Gamble was in the territory in the area.
Troublemakers take over on downs.
And Nekoosa takes over on downs. So that first string defense gets back out there, does the job after the long run by Stample. Clock running down. We'll see if Nekoosa gets a playoff here yet in the third quarter. I don't think they will.
That's going to bring us to the end of the quarter.
They're going to let the clock run down. We've played 3. Our score, Nekoosa 42 and Westfield 6. So the fourth quarter is here. Neil Diamond has gone back to his suite. Wherever Neil Diamond goes. Sweet Caroline here in the entering the fourth period. It's a crowd favorite. First down carry, and that's Nekoosa about Dane 4 Wood. Yards. Dane Woods with a carry.
Crowley, number 80.
So Nekoosa puts up 14 points in the third period. They've outscored Westfield 35 to nothing over the past two periods. After a close 7-6 first quarter. Woods again, just short of that first down. He picks up about five. It's gonna be 31. I expect to see a lot of new faces in the game for Nekoosa here in this second half, or fourth quarter, I should say. Colo hands it off straight ahead. Is that Woods again? No, that's a new player. Number 15 with a carry. That's Clayton Havlovic. Remember seeing Clayton out there carrying the football last season. Havlovic, a junior now, 5'6", 140. He gets the first down, so Nekoosa with a new set of downs, a ball out to the 25-yard line. New quarterback is reported. Who's that new quarterback? Dane Woods, number 10. So Woods moves from running back to quarterback, and Nekoosa's going to take a timeout. 10-11 to play. 42-6, Nekoosa. First and 10 for Nekoosa, ball at the 21-yard line. Dane Woods in at quarterback. Let's see who is in the backfield. I think that's Havlovic. One of the running backs. Big hole. A good run. Head him to the goal line is number 34, Sawyer Niprath, I believe.
Sawyer Niprath finally gets reached down by Kenya.
All the way down to the 5-yard line. Tom, do the math. 74 yards. On the run, Nekoosa first and goal from the 5. Looked like Niprath was gonna be taken down right at the 40-yard line right in front of us, but he just flat out ran over the defender. Showed good speed as well. Niprath behind the quarterback, Woods. Niprath again. Breaks the tackle, but then stumbles down at the 3.
Sawyer Niprath, the ball carrier.
Of the four games Westfield's played, they've hit this 35-point deficit in 3 of those games. Straight up the middle this time. That was Havlovic.
Clayton Havlovic with the carry.
Maybe
brought
a,
down by Carter Stoffacher.
Third down. Clock running. We're down to 8:10. Nekoosa quickly to the line. Niprath short again.
Peyton Freeze.
Freeze on
Niprath.
The stop. And really no gain.
Brings
up
fourth and goal.
Ball still at the 3-yard line. And Nekoosa will probably go for it here. So that Westfield defense. Showing a little bit of toughness right now. Woods over the ball. Keeps it this time. To the edge. Touchdown, Dane Woods.
Touchdown, Papermaker.
Dane Woods takes it 3 yards.
Dane Woods punches it in.
And Nekoosa extends that lead now to 48-6. See if it's Woods or Boudreau now attempting the point. It looks like Dane is still out there. Polo out there again as the holder.
And Woods with the extra point.
Woods now 7 out of 7 on the night. 7:29 to play, 49-6, Nekoosa. Hunter Boudreau has it teed up, and he puts his leg into it. Taken at about the 28-yard line by Freeze. And Freeze with a good return out to the 45. You know, Peyton Freeze has been a key man for Westfield on both offense and defense tonight.
Rodriguez.
And unfortunately right now, Freeze looks like he might have pulled a leg muscle. Pretty slow going back to the sideline. Clock running, 7 minutes to play in this ball game. Nekoosa on top, 49-6. And again, Westfield talking it over on the sideline as they mark the ball for play. Nekoosa still shuffling players in and out defensively. Nekoosa with a five-man front now. Maybe six. That pass knocked down
by John Barton.
By John Barton. As he was in the backfield in a hurry. John playing that left end right now. Nekoosa's going to find the going a little bit tougher next week when Watoma comes to town, but I tell you what, this Nekoosa team's heading in the right direction. Should be a good game. Freeze on the swing pass. Makes a good cut. And he's got a first down. Inside the 45 to about the 44. He's Squirdo with the stop. That name brings back memories, doesn't it? Cody Squirdo and the Kokokas and some pretty good football teams here at Nekoosa High School. First and 10 from the 44, 5:10 to play here in the ballgame. From the shotgun, Gray. Looking for Holly. Overshoots him at about the 20.
Holly, the intended receiver, incomplete.
Boy, Gray threw a nice looking ball that time. Tight spiral. And threw the ball about 35 yards.
Just a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, a little help cleaning up around yourselves before you take off tonight. We greatly appreciate that.
Second down and 10, the ball at the 44. Stanford, right next to the quarterback. Got a man down the sideline, he drops the football. Little bit underthrown, but Cade Kangas was out there, wide open, and Gray, again, left it just a tad short, but Kangas should have caught it. Anyway. Third down for the Pioneers. Yeah. We're going to hand it off to Stanfill this time. And Stanfill, little burst of speed. He's got a first down.
The Squirto brings down Stanfill.
The Squirto put him down at about the 32-yard line. Gain of 12, first down, Westfield. See Eric Peterson on the sideline tonight. He's out there again this season. Getting all kinds of great video of the Nekoosa sports teams. Eric's been doing that for quite a few years now. Stanfill picks his way through the crowd. Short gain of about 3. 2:50 to play. You know, Coach Lieb here for Nekoosa, his third season, he's got a 9-16 overall mark thus far. But in conference games, he's 7-3. So, means the Nekoosa teams get better as the season goes out. Stanfill breaks a tackle, fighting for first down yardage. And I believe he's got it as he's brought down around the 20.
First down for the Pioneers.
So you got to admire the fight of this Westfield team. I don't see anybody giving up out there. They're still playing hard. First and 10. Freeze. Short game, maybe one. Brought down by number 53.
Taking Freeze with the ball.
That's Ben Murray.
Ben Murray.
Ben in the game. That'll make Grandma Joyce happy. Minute 20 to play. Oh yeah, and Grandpa Jim. Hanging on for dear life is number 14. Ortiz with the catch and about a 10-yard gain. I'm not sure who number 14 is for Nekoosa. Under a minute to play now, the ball at the 11-yard line, so it's first and 10. Westfield does have 3 timeouts left. Let's see if they use one here, if they need it, to get in the end zone. Great, gonna keep it. Brought down by number 38, John Barton. That's about the first time, maybe the second or third time, I guess I've seen Gray run tonight, a design run. That one sure didn't go anywhere now, did it? Let's see if they throw to the end zone this time. We're down to 10 seconds. Gray looks that way, got a man over the middle, threw it behind him. But he had Freeze open. And the clock runs down to 0 in this ball game.
Special shout out and thank you to the Pioneers. A close
and a close game in the first
quarter.
And Nekoosa pours it on with 42 unanswered points. Our final tonight, Nekoosa 49 and Westfield 6. So with a win, Nekoosa now 1-4 on the season. They are 1-0 in South Central Conference play. With the loss, Westfield 0-5 on the year, and they are 0-1 in the South Central. Good ball game tonight. Nekoosa led 7-6 after 1 on a Bills 4-yard run. Piled on in the second quarter with another run by, a 43-yard pass from Polo to Mills. A Niprat 2-yard run and a Loebner 6-yard run. Nekoosa led 28-6 at halftime. Third quarter brought a couple more scores for Nekoosa's Gamble. Scored on a 57-yard run, first play of the second half. Dylan Bills followed that up with a 31-yard run. came along, and Dane Woods got involved. He scored on a 3-yard runner final tonight. 49 for Nekoosa and 6 for Westfield. So our congratulations goes out to the Nekoosa football team and Coach Liebherr. And we're looking forward to next Friday night. When Toma comes to town, they'll take on the Papermakers 7 o'clock here at Holland Field. So for Nita Kirst, my name is Tom Kirst. Thank you so much for joining us. See you again next time for Nekoosa Sports.